means I know I don't deserve it, but I still get it because I belong to the family. Now, every one of you belong to some family here, and some family connections aren't the same as others, and some people in your family may not have anything, but some do. And you visualize, you know, you've got this family, and mom and dad, you know, have something in their 401ks and whatever, as you know, and houses and whatever. And inheritance gets passed down to the kids. Not necessarily because they always deserve it, but because they belong to the family. That's the way it goes. That's just the way it goes. You're part of the family, you're part of the inheritance. I like that because I know I don't deserve what God's willing to give me. But I understand this idea of inheritance and belonging to God. Committing myself to Christ means I get the gift. And that was not going away again, back to that issue here. So I've got a better hope that can beat out anything that you could have tucked away in banks, homes, or relationships, or fame, or whatever it is. Now here's the thing about it, as we come down toward the end of the lesson here. This kind of hope frees you from all the issues that we constantly deal with, that worry us, and trouble us, and dismay us, and make us stand on the edge and wonder, is there hope? Well, yeah, there's hope. Because I'm not going to get that taken away from me. Nobody. Paul writes in the book of Romans, and he'll talk about all of these things that we're more than conquerors, and he says, neither life nor death nor any of these things is able to separate us from the love of God. That stays with me. As I can be confident of it, because God promised it.
Amen.
And God doesn't go back on His promises. Not the way we do. Not that we say we always intentionally do, but we just do. But God won't. So it frees me when I've got hope really firmly planted in that. It frees me of all the worries, all the concerns, and it frees me to the power to be able to forgive other people because I want them to have that same hope. So I'm not going to be envious or jealous or troubled. No. I want them to have that hope. I don't lose mine because they have it. I'm happy for them to have it. Even if they've not treated me the way they ought to. It frees me to forgive them and just go on. Relieves me of the stress that I always carry on the back. Things that tighten up the muscles in your shoulders and in the back and troubles your mind and that'll get all sorted out by the God that raised His Son from the dead. I don't know how it's all going to work itself out, but God does. And I trust Him to do a better job sorting it out than I could ever do. So I'm going to put my hope in Him and in the resurrection, knowing that He raised His Son and He's going to do the same thing for me. I like that song we sing. My hope is built on nothing less than Jesus' blood and righteousness. That's what we get through the blood of Christ. Not because of who we are. I dare not trust in anything more, the song says. I need hope, don't you? I'm tired of Satan beating me down like he did the early Christians and making me feel like, boy, this is some days aren't worth living. Because every day is worth living. Every day gives me hope. Every day raises me up and says, you've got something worth living for. Now, not only go out there and act like it, but go out there and share that. Do you see how that kind of hope frees us to be able to do that, too? How blessed we are. So blessed. Now, Peter will go on and talk in this letter about all of these issues that we have. And he'll talk about the trials and all of that stuff. Verse 7, he says, It's just testing the genuineness of your faith. It's easy, you see, to say, oh, I believe in God when everything's just going perfect. The tough as nails when it's not. But when you've got your hope in the right place, you're going the right direction. Think about it. Wrestle on it. Pray about it when you go home. Look in the mirror and ask yourself about it. Just you individually. Don't look at anybody else. Just you in the mirror. Have a discussion. And include God in it. And we're singing the song at the close.